Well, I want to thank everybody for their participation. I would note this is a historic day in a number of ways. 25 years ago, Hezbollah bombed the Jewish center in Buenos Aires, killing 85 innocent civilians. We recognize that, and we remember. And we remember that this continues to take place. So these are the things that we hope to stop, and the natures and things of that nature. We believe this is a global crisis and requires a global response. We have historic levels of persecution and response. We've made history here, largest international religious freedom gathering in the history of mankind. We had almost 900 members of religious groups and civil societies, 36 panels, 186 speakers the first 2 days. Day three, the government day, 106 governments from every region of the world. Followed up conferences announced by the Vatican, Morocco, Albania, Colombia, Bangladesh, and the Marshall Islands. At the UN Security Council announcements of a meeting on August 22nd, called by Poland to remember victims of persecution. New funds were announced for those who have been persecuted. Taiwan announced putting in $1 million to the International Religious Freedom Fund. There are 9 statements, which you can still join, but we will be collecting right at the end of this presentation and of the conference. Since last year, we've seen 3 new religious freedom ambassadors appointed from Mongolia, Taiwan, and announced today from the Netherlands. We will be approaching a number of you about helping us to structure and build out this first ever international body of the International Religious Freedom Alliance that the Secretary announced this morning. We believe there needs to be something that's on a permanent basis to track and push on this issue of religious freedom that is so pronounced and going on aggressively. We need to head this off, and we need to be serious about it. There will be grassroots efforts of the effort to form nearly 100 religious freedom roundtables in all around the world, where religious leaders, civil society get together to support each other's right to religious freedom. There have been about 10 of those stood up already. I meet regularly with the one here in Washington, and we're hopeful to see those really grow around the world so they get the civil society and religious groups involved in various nations pushing and promoting this. I have several groups to thank. First of all, you for coming and for being a part of this. You honor us by your attendance and your participation. I know this is an unusual gathering on religious freedom because there just haven't been that many before, but the crisis is so severe and significant. We felt it important, and we did it last year, and we've got our feet wet and did it. It went bigger, and we think better this year, and more actions were announced because we think actions are needed. So we first of all thank all of you for being willing to participate and be a part of this global effort that is just so, so needed. I also want to thank the office team and the State Department here, my office, International Religious Freedom Office, and the people associated with them have put in a lot of hours to see this come together. As many of you that have done these before know, they don't just happen or drop out of the air. It takes a lot of effort, and I'm deeply appreciative to all the staff here at State Department and protocol and the diplomatic security for their work of putting this all together. If you'd join me in giving them a round of applause, I would appreciate that.